Well, Dimitri, are you finally going to tell us the damn truth?
What are you talking about?
Didn't Lord Arendelle say something about you and Edelgard being family?
To claim that the king and the emperor are related. Could it be?
Ah, I suppose I never told you. Though I do recall mentioning it briefly to the professor. Lord Arendelle spoke the truth. My stepmother was Edelgard's birth mother. Political turmoil drove my stepmother out of the Empire. Father fell in love with her at first sight, and they married. I lost my birth mother before I was old enough to remember her. My stepmother filled that role for me.
Kind of.
But she lost her life in Dusker 9 years ago, along with father.
Hang on. I didn't even know she was your stepmother. Did my father know about this?
Yes. All those who were close to my father knew, including Rodrigue. But to speak openly about it would have caused a scandal. And so she was our secret. No one in the general public knew about her. Naturally, the fact that Edelgard and I are step-siblings was kept a secret as well.
I'm finally beginning to understand what you went through 5 years ago. I mean, Edelgard is the only family you have left, isn't she?
Mm.
To find out someone so precious to you is actually your most hated enemy. How heartbreaking.
But wait! You two were born and raised in two different territories, right? So you probably never met until you were both at the academy. I mean, don't get me wrong. I think the idea of fighting family is just about the worst thing ever. But hopefully the fact that she's a stepsister who you never really knew helps with the pain? I don't know. It was just a thought.
I'm afraid that's not the case. Though it was only for a short time, Edelgard once called Ferdia at home. It was a long time ago, but she was a cherished friend of mine.
Wait! I remember now. She was that girl, wasn't she? The one you gave a dagger to. So, your little girlfriend was Edelgard.
Sylphain, if you have any more foolish things to say, please hold them for later.
I do have a few more in my sleeve, but they can wait. Go on, Your Highness. This is important for us to hear.
She may be a hated enemy now, but the Emperor is your old friend and your stepsister. Can you bring yourself to kill her?
I will kill her, if I must. But if there is any chance that the world she seeks to create could be a just one, then I would love to see a future in which I may reach out my hand for her and have her reach back.
It's not gonna happen.
That said, right? I have no intention of letting my personal feelings cloud my judgment. Too much is at stake.
Edelgard is so stubborn.
I think you should meet with the Emperor and at least try to talk to her. If there's any hope of ending this war without more bloodshed, we have to try. Besides, killing your own family. I'm sorry, but it's not right.
I think so too. And you are right that we should at least try.
Okay, that's fair enough.
I see. So my uncle's defeat is beyond doubt?
Yes, Your Majesty. I have confirmed it via countless channels. I advise that we accept this as a drop of joy amid a pool of sorrow.
Pretty words, but I'm afraid we can't rest until the joy outweighs the sorrow. And for that to happen, it now seems we must confront them all at once. Dimitri, who took back Ferdiad, Claude, who managed to protect the Alliance, and that professor, who is successfully mobilizing the Knights of Seros.
What will you do, Your Majesty?
Pull back our forces. In the west to Arion Road. In the east to...
Fort Mercius, I presume. There is no better place for such a confrontation, after all.
Indeed. And dispatch the Death Knight to guard it. He can buy us some time. In the meantime, I will...
Forgive me, but I must speak bluntly. I do not agree with what you intend to do. Though slight, there is a chance that once done, it cannot be undone.
This music's so good. The Empire music.
Even I cannot always choose the direction my path leads me. There is no other way. And so, I must walk on.
Yeah, she doesn't seem to want to talk anything.
Part 2. Azure Moon. Blue Sea Moon. The Impregnable Fortress. When Claude steps down as its leader, the Lester Alliance disbands, and its lords swear fealty to the Holy Kingdom of Fargus. The chaos in the kingdom begins to dissipate as the people unite under Dimitri's rule.
Cool.
Riding this momentum, The Kingdom Army prepares to march south for a decisive battle against Imperial forces.
We are advancing, dudes. We're doing it. So close to the end, right? That should be very close. Uh-huh. It's Caspar's birthday. Oh yeah, let's go to the tea party. Something energetic, maybe? Bright notes? Revitalizes, refreshes, maybe that one? Calms, concentration? No. He's gonna want the
meat. Hey, Professor, got something interesting to share? Thanks.
Hello, Caspar.
Delicious.
God, I love him.
Yeah.
School days books I've read recently. I guess it's shareable with snacks.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Huh?
Ooh. I guess fish?
Yeah.
Of course it's fish.
Yeah.
Heart racing memories, overcoming weaknesses, gathering missions. Overcoming weaknesses.
I get it now. I'm gonna keep training until I can beat you.
Okay. Not, I guess. Never. I can never
Thanks
do
for
it.
This, Professor. Don't you want to get some exercise, though? Come on, let's go train.
Fucking hell. What up?
We will finally have our decisive battle
Good
with
music.
The Empire this month.
The Eastern Lords are in the process of consolidating all of the troops within the entire kingdom. In addition, ever since Arian Rhodes' liberation, the Western Lords have been declaring their fealty, one after another.
After all this time, I haven't managed to do it yet.
Affairs within the kingdom have calmed down considerably, and we even managed to win over the Alliance.
Although it was a rough go at first, I'm starting to feel like we could actually win this. That's true. Thinking back on it now, we've really come a long way.
Yeah, we
even have a lead as to where Rhea is located. It is as we predicted all along. If we are to rescue Rhea, then we must defeat the Emperor.
If we're going to march from the monastery to Inbar, then we'll have to cross the Great Bridge of Murden again, right?
The Great Bridge
yes,
of Murden.
I believe so. As we have gained the Alliance's support, we should not have any trouble this time. After the bridge, we can cross Gronder Field and head south. And then we'll take Mercius, the so-called impregnable fortress that towers on the other side.
Impregnable fortress?
Fort Mercius. I know of it. They say it rivals even Arian Road.
Ooh. Count Burgles, the Empire's Minister of Military Affairs, once had troops stationed there. But according to our spies, a large-scale military force has entered the stronghold. Perhaps they are gathering soldiers from various regions to compensate for their losses.
Hmm. Can we really prevail?
It is unlike you to worry so. But I feel we have no choice but to strip that place of its impregnable reputation. Once we take Fort Mercius, Enbar will be within reach. This is the Empire's last chance to stop us from arriving at our goal.
In other words, if we take this fort, then our blades will be at the Emperor's throat in no time.
If this is the last fort between us and them, then the Emperor will likely do everything she can to strengthen its defenses.
I just received a report on that very subject. The one commanding the troops stationed at Fort Mercius is someone we have crossed blades with many times. It is the Death Knight who awaits us there.
Oh, of course.
Oh, so that's who we'll be battling. Emil.
Fucking Emil. We did beat him with Caspar. I think we are motivated this time, right? kind of. Oh, he's maxed out. Look at that. I don't think we need to do that, though. Support. Oh, God. What does happen this week? Yeah, this one's probably one of the best. We'll do it so we can get these S ranks soon. Yes, I did. It was very hard.
Age is but a number.
I suppose it's working.
But I did it. It was quite a debacle that day. It was very tense, but we did it. And Dimitri's using the scythe, which he used to destroy Lord Arundel. So that was fun. Oh, that's a misclick. That's a misclick.
Thanks.
Bad. I need to give him that S rank. God, he's done with this. Do I give him a little bit of, like, this? I guess this is useful. He fucking hates it, but it's pretty useful. Maybe if we can give him a better battalion for the late game. It was tragic. Hey, Ginger, welcome. God, those S ranks are gonna be so hard to get. Maybe we won't be able to get them.
My.
Kaspar.
Think that way.
Hey guys, boss. God, we need the motivation though. Soon enough. Begin training. One exploration on me. Hey professor, I think I'm ready. I think it's time for finally give me a nickname. What you guys gotta do to earn one? It's too scary to say it out loud. He's gonna love that one.
Yeah, great answer.
I knew she'd like it. Hey, thanks, Ginger. We're all epic as fuck. Hopefully. He's pretty epic. What he is, he's not an elk. That's definitely, you know, the thing.
It'll be. You can count.
You can count on me. Pretty nice.
Perhaps I'll expand.
I always would.
Sounds a clean day. Let's do it. Let's get that fucking hymn going. Yeah,
regardless
sing,
of
ladies.
The quality, they won't notice if one person doesn't sing, will they?
Very cute. It's Flynn's birthday. Let's go. You're gonna like Angelic.
I am honored that you invited me. I am ever so grateful.
Good.
Delicious.
Right. Oh my God. Ooh. Oh, I don't know. Think you're romantic?
Yes.
Hope for your future? Good. Working on regards, think your friends are. Come on.
Have you any idea how many types of fish there are? It is unthinkable. They're different sizes, shapes, colors. Oh, I find it fascinating.
Hmm. chat.
That tea was very delicious.
I can't do it, dude. I can't do it. It's too much.
Death Knight. Going to fight the Death Knight. You're right. I'll have to face him eventually.
Great magic. And there's Manuel and Flynn.
Professor, so...
I feel like I know almost nothing with playing most of the runs against the Death Knight, except the blue one. Of course, I haven't finished it. So I feel like there's going to be some stuff, cool stuff revealed
the
about
Death
him.
Death Knight. I shudder to think of him, Professor.
Probably not.
You remember my connection
to him.
There's
nothing else.
Do you not? I am still working through the trauma from back then. All these years later, if we meet him, I swear I will have my revenge.
Cool. Get that revenge, girl. That's right, girl. Get it, girl. Hey.
Each step closer to Enbar, I'm reminded of another part of my past. Riches and poverty, glory and failure. That city has it all. And if I'm honest, sometimes I miss it. That's
you
how the
don't
past
have
works,
to fight
though,
him.
Isn't it? It's always a different story than what you really lived.
Support.
Ah, hello. Dudu, yes?
Finished praying?
I am, yes. You have grown much since I saw you last. You're a man now.
You barely know me.
True.
Wow.
I suppose we did only meet a handful of times.
Nice dude to do.
As haggard as you look now, you were even worse when I last saw you in the capital.
Haggard, eh? True enough.
Still weighed down by the same regret, I see.
I was unable to protect the king. That is the ultimate failure. One I must atone for.
If you have the spare time to beg forgiveness, then pick up a lance and train.
Jeez, the dude don't like Gilbert at all.
That would do nothing to atone for the dead.
Your prayers are mere self-indulgence.
You do not understand.
Oh.
No, I do not. Fargus needed you. His Highness needed you.
There was no other choice but for me to leave. What would you have done if you were in my place? If His Highness had died due to your failures?
If he commanded me to live, then I would live. Otherwise, I would die with him. I have nothing left to lose other than His Highness, home, family, all but that man I have already lost.
Destroyed.
You were a knight in service to the king for decades. Not only did you excel in bravery, wisdom, and tactics, but in matters of character, you were an ideal knight, utterly above reproach. That is what His Highness has always said. I have only come this far by modeling my conduct after his stories of you, but now...
Forget those words spoken by His Highness. I am no different a man than I was before, beaten down by sin, alone and weak. I am lost and irredeemable.
Jesus. That was a great mood. Conversation put him in a great mood. Oh yes, A+. Oh, they have to marry, come on.
Now the flowers are all taken care of. Huh? Felix? Why are you hiding there?
I'm not hiding.
No? Then what are you here for? You don't even have a real reason, do you?
No, I don't.
Then why?
Because of you.
What? What's that supposed to mean?
I want you to sing for me. I hear your voice when I'm asleep or in battle. It's like I'm your captive.
My captive? What are you saying? Oh my, I'm suddenly really flustered.
I can't help it. I don't know what I'm saying. Forget I said anything.
Felix, are you blushing?
I don't know. Shut up. I'm not blushing.
Well, if you feel like that about it, I suppose I could sing for you sometimes. If you like that sort of thing.
Oh? I'd better go. Bye.
Hey, wait! You just got here! Do you want to hear me sing or not?
Yes, I do.
Well, what song do you want me to sing? Bears, swamp beasties, foxes, or dungeon?
I'd like to hear all of them, if you don't mind. Starting with the library song in full. Sing for me, please, Annette?
Well, okay. Just this once.
God, that was the cutest shit I ever seen. He's the number one fan.
Is something the matter? Your heart does not seem to be in your training today.
I'm sorry. Something's been bothering me.
Idle thoughts do hinder training. Tell me what bothers you.
You were sworn to protect the royal family. But when we met 5 years ago, you weren't in the kingdom capital. You were in Garrig Muck. What could have made a great knight like you abandon his vow?
That is difficult to explain. You are aware of the tragedy of Dusker? When the king's party was massacred 9 years ago.
I am. It affected me too. My brother was suspected of being involved in the attack. So the church, they...
Forgive me. That must be a difficult memory.
Why are you apologizing? It's not your fault.
I disagree. Had I been by His Majesty's side on that day, where I was sworn to be, perhaps His Majesty would not have lost his life, and all would be different.
Is that why you left Fargus?
Yes. You may laugh, but I feel I was responsible for everything.
I would never laugh at something like that, but I do think you should have seen things through to the end. Even if you had to endure dishonor for a while, you could have restored your name. I'm sorry. That was inconsiderate of me. I got carried away by how much your situation resembles my own.
You were adopted by Lord Lonato, correct? I once told you that I wish to protect one thing other than my king. And that is my family.
I do like Gilbert, though. Gilbert a bit, though. His character is so far from perfect. I like when there's characters like that in your rank. He's not, look, not all super good guys or super perfect dudes that make no mistakes. I like it.
My wife and my daughter, both of whom I left behind in the kingdom. Lord Lonato took up his sword for his son, even if that meant turning his back on the goddess. As a father, I cannot condemn Lord Lonato for raising an army. Yet, perhaps he too lost sight of what should be protected, just as I did.
I don't understand what you mean. What should Lonato have protected?
You, Ash. Because you are also his son.
You're right. I think I know what I need to protect now. It's been staring me in the face all this time. I don't know why I couldn't see it. I'm Lonato's son. His pride and his wishes are my inheritance. Those are what I should protect.
I see. Ash, you will be an excellent knight.
It's too early to say that, but I'm willing to learn if you'll teach me.
It would be my pleasure to oversee the training of a new generation.
Good. Good support. Loved it. Burning Casper? Yes!
Come on, Bernadetta, open up. Why are you so mad at me? I have no clue what this is about, but I'm sorry.
You have no clue? Don't you remember what you did to me?
No. I didn't do anything.
Yes, you did. You did all kinds of things. But the worst thing was carrying me off twice. I thought I might die.
What are you even talking about?
Don't act like you never took me to that place.
I love
it. What place? Why won't you? Oh, the place with the pretty view. Why are you mad about that?
Because you hold me around like a piece of luggage.
Again, why are you mad about that?
Don't act all surprised. How would you feel to be yanked around like that?
I'm sorry, I didn't realize I was just excited to show it to you. Maybe I went a little overboard. I'm real sorry about that.
You are? Well, I hope you understand now.
I definitely do, and I feel awful about it. What can I do to make it up to you? Anything you want. I want to show you how seriously sorry I am.
Well, all right. I'd like you to, bring me to that place again. But promise me two things first.
Anything.
No carrying, no pulling around. Treat me gently.
Sure, sure, of course. No problem. But that was three things, not two.
That was one thing. Be gentle, okay?
Oh, okay. Sorry. What's the other thing?
I want you to promise not to take anyone else there. Only me.
Oh. All right, I can promise that. Seems a little strange, though. Why do you care?
Come on. If you really want to apologize, hurry up and take me there.
Right, on it. Here we are. Oh, look at that gorgeous sunset.
This is it. Same view. After all that time inside, the sun feels like it's piercing right through me.
This little bit of sunshine? You really gotta get outside more. From now on, I'm gonna take you to all sorts of different places. I promise I'll be gentle, and I promise I won't take anyone else. Just you and me, all right?
What? But... okay. But if you get sick of me, I'm sorry ahead of time.
What? Good one, Bernadetta.
It's beautiful. All right. I'll save just in case. We've been exploring for some time. Yeah. Finish the day. We have to get Dimitri S. I don't think I'll be able to do it. We could try. Oh, he's already S. S plus. I'm not sure if I've managed to get it though.
Hey,
I'll try. Oh, Mercy's super close too. He's a talented boss. It's so far away. Ugh. Can we get you 2S at least? I guess I wanted something better with him. Just stop complaining. Just do it. I never had a bad Kaspar. Never. And I played Black Eagles twice, and here we recruited him. So, of the three times, never. Oh shit, I forgot the Golden Felix. God, I'm a failure. I wasted some points. Doubt it matters, though. God, that's so bad. We're gonna give him... Fuck it, I don't know, authority and that's it. I don't really care about anything else. Seminar for Lancers. We need to train... Ooh. Wait, no, that's Dimitri. I want to teach Dimitri Lancers. Ooh. What else? Oh, this is good, too. Yeah, let's do that one. I'll do another one later. We have to get Dimitri to S+. A+.
This experience is critical.
Good.
All the more reason to...
This will help keep me alive.
I want to see it. Instruct. Perfect. Perfect.
Yes.
Yes, Dimitri. Yes.
No.
Fantastic. Oh, so it is excellent.
I've this.
This. It shouldn't have. I didn't put the abilities on. Four more. My goodness. I want the A plus. I think this is how you get plus one movement. Yeah, boy. More perfect. Do it. Oh, that's fine.
I would like.
I'll check it out now. Not. There you go.
Professor.
What was the last kill? As a lord? Fuck it. It really is very late. Why do you have swords? What the fuck? Oh, I changed it by accident. I'm never gonna get that plus. Ooh, meteor. This is a chaos. I thought it was Lance and Authority, right? Oh, come on. Did any of you teach Lance, bros? Sure, let's do that one. Well, just in case, if he's, you know, in the field of battle and he finds a sword or something.
This experience is critical.
I think I'm improving.
I'll make good.
Shut up.
Yeah.